بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Alhamdulillah, respected brothers and sisters and listeners, we're continuing with our nightly Ramadan reminders. And Alhamdulillah that this Mubarak month, as we mentioned previously, all of us know that this is a blessed month of the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن, that this Mubarak month of Ramadan is the month in which the Quran was revealed. So the fasting in the Quran, brothers and sisters, it has a direct connection. As is mentioned in another hadith, الصيام والقرآن يشفعاني, that the fasting and the Quran will intercede on behalf of its doer. In other words, on the Day of Judgment, the Quran, the recitation of the Quran as an amal, as an action, it will come in favor and it will argue in favor of a person that, Ya Allah, Quran will say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, mana'atuhu an-nawm. Oh Allah, I prevented him from his sleep. Ya Rabbil Alameen. In other words, like in these Mubarak nights, we usually stand in Taraweeh and we listen to the Quran and, you know, we try to achieve, you know, one juz a night, and we try to achieve a khatam in the month of Ramadan. So, you know, it prevents us from, you know, sleeping 1 hour earlier. We could, if we want, go to sleep 1 hour earlier. And standing in that 20 rakats and, you know, persevering, and, you know, some of the rakats get extremely long and some of the recitations get a little bit lengthy. But despite that, what do we do? Out of the love for the Qur'an and out of the love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and reverence for His blessed book, we stand those nights. And this is where the Qur'an, subhanAllah, when we tolerate the hardship and we honor and revere the Qur'an as the Qur'an is to be revered, standing with the Qur'an, with the Qari, either ourselves or behind the Qari who is reciting on our behalf, we are standing in reverence of that book. That book, where we stood with it in this life, will not leave us in the next life. It will remember us. And it will intercede for us before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What will it say? Exactly this. مَنَعَتُهُ النَّوْمُ. Oh Allah, forgive this person. Because I prevented him from his rest. I prevented him from his sleep. I prevented him from his comfort. He made himself uncomfortable for my sake. For the sake of your kalam, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. So the Qur'an will intercede on behalf of its reciter on the Day of Judgment. And similarly, it's siyam. Subhanallah, look at how both of these things go together. Al-Qur'an wa siyam, yashfa'ani. The Qur'an, yani the tilawat of the Qur'an, will intercede. And fasting will intercede before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and argue in favor of the one who was reciting or the one who was fasting for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, either in the month of Ramadan or outside the month of Ramadan. And it will say, مَنَعْتُهُ الطَّعَامَ وَالشَّرَابَ وَالشَّهْوَةَ, that Ya Allah, I prevented him from food and drink and his desires. And then what will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do? فَيَشْفَعَانِ, right? Or فَيُشَفَّعَانِ. Their intercession will be accepted on behalf of its doer. So subhanallah, the month of Ramadan, the fasting and the Quran are two intercessors. Yani they will intercede, they will make shafa'a, they will argue in favor of its doer, the Quran and the fasting. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those whose Quran and reciting of the Quran and fasting of the month of Ramadan becomes a true intercessor on our behalf. And when will it become an intercessor on our behalf? When it truly has that effect, when we do it out of sincerity, and when we do it with that intention that, Ya Rabbil Alameen, I am doing this in reverence of your book, and in honor of your book, and in love of your kalam and your words. And oh Allah, I am doing this, imanan wa ihtisaban, with faith in this obligation of the fasting, and hoping for its reward, inshaAllah ta'ala, that this fasting and the Quran on the Day of Judgment will come as intercessors on our behalf, inshaAllah ta'ala. May Allah ta'ala include us to be from amongst them. With that being said, inshaAllah, tonight's dars and tonight's reminder is going to be again from Imam Al-Qurtubi's book, the great Mufassir of the Quran, التذكار في أفضل الأذكار, the reminder in regards to the best of remembrances, the most virtuous of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we mentioned, is the tilawat of the Quran. There is no remembrance and there is no dhikr and there is no means of attaining proximity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in comparison to the Quran. There is nothing like the Quran in drawing near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we mentioned previously. Tonight, inshallah, Imam al-Qurtubi has an amazing chapter. And I'm reading from various different chapters from this book, At-Tidhkar fi Afdal al-Athkar of Imam al-Qurtubi. He has in Al-Bab al-Thamin wal-Ashroon, chapter 28 of this book, fi daf'i al-bala'i bita'allum al-Qur'an wa biqira'at al-Qur'an. The chapter on how calamities are removed by the teaching of the Qur'an. And obviously, when you are teaching the Qur'an, you are reciting the Qur'an. Brothers and sisters, this is a very, very important chapter, and it's a very important subject and a topic that has a lot to do with this COVID-19 and this situation and circumstances that we are in today, where the entire world is involved in and the whole world is taken over by. And that is this adversity that has come upon mankind. What is one of the most, the best ways of removing a calamity, or the best way of removing the displeasure of Allah, is to attain the rahmah of Allah. The way to remove the displeasure and anger of Allah is to attract the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to attract the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to attract the sakina and the special attention of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the kindness and benevolence of Allah azza wa jal. And there is nothing that we can achieve the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than the tilawat of the Quran Kareem. And inshallah, I wanted to read what Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah mentions. He says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَذَكَرَ أَبُو مُحَمَّدَ الدَّارِمِيُّ فِي مُسْنَدِهِ. And Abu Muhammad al-Darimi, Imam al-Darimi is one of the Imams of Hadith. He has a book called the Musnad, the Musnad of Imam al-Darimi. He says, قَالَ أَخْبَرَنَا مَرْوَانُ بْنُ مُحَمَّدٍ قَالَ أَخْبَرَنَا رَفْدَ الْغَسَّانِي قال أخبرني ثابت بن عجلان الأنصاري قال كان يقال إن الله تعالى ليريد العذاب بأهل الأرض فإذا سمع تعليم الصبيان الحكمة صرف ذلك عنهم قال مروان يعني بالحكمة القرآن رواه الدارمي في فضائل القرآن. إمام الدارمي narrates from ثابت بن عجلان الأنصاري that it was used to be said, يعني the Salaf al-Salihin and the pious predecessors from amongst the Tabi'een, and perhaps, you know, they had attained this from the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, that verily Allah Azza wa Jal, he wants, or because of something that brings about his anger, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he wants to descend upon a people, and the decision is not made, but there are certain things that is making Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala angry. The displeasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking place on the earth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He wills or He wishes to punish them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى لَيُرِيدُ الْعَذَابَ بِأَهْلِ الْأَرْضِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when this displeasure is taking place upon the earth, and they are incurring Allah's punishment and wrath through their actions, meaning, they could be deserving of Allah Ta'ala's wrath and Allah's punishment. فَإِذَا سَمِعَ تَعْلِيمَ الصِّبِيَانِ الْحِكْمَةَ. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hears that the children are being taught the Qur'an, يعني الْحِكْمَةَ, the wisdom. يعني Marwani explains, what is the meaning of hikmah? يعني wisdom, the Qur'an, the wisdom of the Qur'an. صَرَفَ ذَلِكَ عَنْهُمْ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removes the calamity, and Allah Ta'ala removes the azab which was intended upon them. And brothers and sisters, this is not something which is far-fetched. Subhanallah, this hadith shows that when the children are reciting the Quran, and we are having the halaqat and the maktabs, where we, subhanallah, in our masajid, we have the makatib, and we have the places where the children are reciting Quran. We have the places where the children are reciting and making tilawat of the Quran. Those are the places where the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends. As is mentioning in a hadith of Sahih Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentions, لا يجتمع قوم في بيت من بيوت الله يتلون كتاب الله ويتدارسونه فيما بينهم. That any group of people who gather to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in recitation of the Quran. And what are they doing? يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ. They are reciting the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَتَدَارَسُونَهُ فِي مَا بَيْنَهُمْ. And they are studying the book of Allah. So either they're gathered together in one of the houses of Allah ta'ala, or they're gathered together in a place which is specified for Allah ta'ala's remembrance. And any place where Allah ta'ala is remembered, the ulama mentioned this could be masjid, or any place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is remembered, and is that place becomes specified, it becomes known as baytun min buyutillah. And it could be al-masajid, aw al-bayt alladhi yudhkaru fi hasmullahi ta'ala. So he says, any group of people who gather together in one of the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, reciting the book of Allah, and studying the book of Allah amongst themselves, what happens? Illa حَفَّتْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ, except that the angels surround them. Subhanallah. وَنَزَلَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ السَّكِينَةِ, and what happens? The nur of sakina descends upon them. Number three, وَغَشِيَتْهُمُ الرَّحْمَةِ, and the mercy of Allah covers them and envelops them. وَذَكَرَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَنْ عِنْدَهِ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remembers those people who are reciting the Quran and studying the Quran in a more nobler and blessed gathering in the Mala'ul A'la with the angels. Allah is mentioning and Allah boasts about those people who are reciting Quran in front of His angels. Brothers and sisters, subhanAllah, these are the four blessings. When we are reciting the Quran in our home, when we are reciting the Quran in the masajid, when the teaching and the learning of the Quran is taking place in a particular area, then we have to understand that that area is in aman. That area is in safety and in security. That area is in Allah's blessings. That area is in Allah's care. That area is in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number one, حَفَّتْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. Imagine. Always remember, brothers and sisters, that the angels love the tilawat of the Qur'an. They love the tilawat of the Qur'an. The angels and the Qur'an, they are like لازم ملزوم. Remember this. The angels and the Qur'an is lazim malzum. Lazim malzum means what? It's when one is there, then the other one will automatically be there. Know this, that when the Qur'an is being recited, and the dhikr of Allah is being made, know that the malaika will most definitely be in that area, will most definitely be in attendance. Subhanallah. The angels love the tilawat of the Qur'an. And this is mentioned, that when the angels hear the tilawat of the Qur'an, they hear the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they call amongst each other, as is mentioned in another hadith, that there are angels. إِنَّ لِلَّهِ مَلَائِكَةً سَيَّاحِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has angels that are literally roaming around and they are seeking the hilaqu dhikr. And what dhikr, as we already mentioned, the most superior dhikr is kalamullah. The most superior dhikr is the recitation of the book of Allah. They actually are looking for these majalis and looking for those places where the recitation of Quran is happening, where the dhikr and the remembrance of Allah Ta'ala is being made. And when one of the angels finds that place where the Quran is being recited or dhikr is being made, he calls the other malaik and says, halimu ila hajatikum. And what happens? حَفَّتْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. The angels literally surround themselves with their wings around that place, around that person, around that halaqa, around that circle, around those people who are reciting the Qur'an. The angels surround them. Subhanallah. Imagine, brothers and sisters, that we are reciting the Qur'an. We are in the masjid, or we are at home with our families. Nowadays, subhanallah, we gather around the TV and people, you know, we watch TV together with the family. We sit around the dastarkhan, you know, around the table or around the sufra, and we're, you know, eating together, having iftari together. You know, we're sitting together around, you know, with tea and biscuits with the family and joking together and telling stories to one another. Subhanallah, can we not get together in our homes and recite the Quran together? Subhanallah, and attain this great blessing the blessing of having the angels to join in our gatherings. Do we think when we're watching television, the angels are going to join us? Or when we're doing anything else of ghafla, or of Allah Ta'ala's forgetfulness, or Allah's unmindfulness? When we gather together to remember Allah, when we gather together to make dhikr of Allah, and to recite the Qur'an together as a family, that one of us recites and the other one listens, or we are correcting one another in each other's tajweed, or the parents are teaching their children, or we are practicing surahs to one another. Here, dear son, listen to my tilawat, and I will listen to your tilawat. Am I reading my surahs correctly? Let me read my suratul mulk to you. You read surah Yasin to me. Listen to me if I'm reciting my juz correctly. See if I have any mistakes. And when we are reciting in yatadarasunahu fima baynahum, subhanallah, you're not alone in that gathering, but the angels, they are in your gathering. And who are the angels, brothers and sisters? Subhanallah. The angels are the ones who Allah has created them. لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. They do not disobey Allah. They are pure and innocent creatures. They are created from light. When you sit in the, and when the malaika are in your company, and when you're sitting in the company of the malaika, and they are your companions, the sifat of the malaika, the qualities of the angels, the attributes of the angels, they start to make intiqal inside of you. They start to rub off upon you. They start to go and start, affecting you. You start absorbing the nuraniyat. You start absorbing the spiritual blessings of those malaika. You start absorbing the ruhaniyat, right? The effulgence, the light, the spirituality, the goodness, the mercy, and the ita'ah, and the obedience, and the taslim, and all of the good qualities of the malaika, they start being absorbed inside of you. Because an-nafsu, right? An-nafsu tasriqu min an-nafsi min haythu la tadri. That one nafs, one self, one entity, it absorbs the qualities of the company that it sits in. Right? That a person will be according to who he sits with and his company. Now imagine the person who the malaika is sitting in him, in his company. The malaika is, when you're reading Quran, you're sitting alone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is listening to your recitation. And the malaika are present in attendance of your recitation. Subhanallah, this is the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. حفتهم الملائكة. And also to understand, when the malaika are not there, when the malaika are there, then what? The shayateen cannot be there. وما تنزلت به الشياطين وما ينبغي لهم وما يستطيعون إنهم عن السمع لمعزولون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, وما تنزلت به الشياطين. And the shayateen, the devils, did not descend with this Quran. وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لَهُمْ. And neither is this ever appropriate for them. وَمَا يَسْتَطِيعُونَ. Actually, they cannot even do that. إِنَّهُمْ عَنِ السَّمْعِ لَمَعْزُولُونَ. Actually, the shayateen cannot even listen to what the Qur'an is being recited. When the shayateen hear the Qur'an, they're running the other direction. And the malaika, where they hear the Qur'an, they are there in presence because they love the Qur'an and they love the recitation of the Qur'an. So brothers and sisters, subhanallah, it mentions here in one hadith, subhanallah, that when the Quran is being recited, in a hadith of Sahih Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentions, لا تجعلوا بيوتكم مقابر. Do not make your homes like graveyards. Just like a graveyard is completely empty. There's no amal in a graveyard, right? There's no recitation of Quran and salat, and dhikr, and movement, and it's not alive, it's dead. People, the amal come to an end. إِذَا مَاتُ ابْنُ آدَمَ انْقَطَعَ عَنْهُ عَمَلُهُ. When a person passes away, all of his deeds come to an end. So, here the Prophet ﷺ is saying, لَا تَجْعَلُوا بُيُوتَكُمْ مَقَابِرٍ. Do not make your houses like graveyards. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَنْفِرُ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ الَّذِي يُقْرَأُ فِيهِ سُورَةُ الْبَقَرَةِ. That shaitan runs away from that home in which Surah Baqarah is recited. Not only Surah Baqarah, but any surah, but especially Suratul Baqarah. And he runs away. And why is that? And he becomes completely hopeless because of the barakah of the surah. This surah has so much barakah in it because of the Asma'ullahi Ta'ala, as is mentioned by Mullah Ali Qari, rahimahullah, لِكَثْرَةِ أَسْمَاءِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى وَالْأَحْكَامِ فِيهَا. Because of the ahkam that is mentioned there, and because of the abundant names of Allah, Ayatul Kursi, which is the greatest verse of the Qur'an, inshallah we will speak about it another night. Ayatul Kursi, which is the greatest ayah of the entire Qur'an, is in Surah Baqarah. آمَنَ الرَّسُولِ, right? The last two ayats, which was specially revealed with malaika, right? The malaika descended with the last two verses of Surah Al-Baqarah, right? This is this is also in Surah Al-Baqarah, right? With the shayateen run away. So where, brothers and sisters, where the Quran is, the angels will be. And where the angels will be, the shayateen cannot be there. Nowadays, we have so much arguments in our house, fighting, arguments, disputes, constant fighting and you know, yelling and screaming, and you know, everybody's just, you know, sometimes the house becomes, we say, this house is like a living hell. Why is this happening? Hell is the place of shayateen, because the shaitans have become so abundant, right? Watching of, you know, evil things on the television, shameful things and evil things, right? Then obviously the shaitan are going to increase. But when the recitation of the Quran is going to take place, وَمَا تَنَزَّلَتْ بِهِ الشَّيَاطِينَ وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لَهُمْ وَمَا يَسْتَطِيعُونَ إِنَّهُمْ عَنِ السَّمْعِ لَمَعْزُولُونَ. Understand this, brothers and sisters, the shayateen cannot even come near listening to it. The moment they hear it, they hate it. They want to run away from it. And the malaika, when you're reciting the Quran, know that the malaika are there. And when the malaika is your companion, you are absorbing from their qualities. Their qualities are obedience of Allah. The person who is reciting the Quran and he is in the company of the angels, obedience of Allah comes inside of him. Tasleem comes inside of him. Love for Allah. The angels love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Love for Allah ta'ala comes inside of that person. And a desire to do good things comes inside of a person. A hatred for bad things comes inside of a person. All of this is what? All of this through the barakat of the reciting of the Quran and the company of the angels, which a person attains through that. That's number one. حفتهم الملائكة. When we gathering, when we reciting the Quran, the angels are descending there. ونزلت عليهم السكينة. Number two, what happens when we gather together to recite the Quran? نزلت عليهم السكينة. And even if you're not in a large group of people, even by yourself, when you are reciting the Quran, the sakina descends. What is sakina? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, هو الذي أنزل السكينة في قلوب المؤمنين لِيَزْدَادُوا إِيمَانًا مَعَ إِيمَانِهِمْ. Allah is the one who brings down the nur of sakina. Some people say, some of the mufassirin say, that sakina is the name of an angel. Allahu Akbar. It's the name of a special angel that descends upon the hearts at the time of reciting of the Quran, or at the time of dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or at the special time when Allah ta'ala wills. هُوَ الَّذِي. Allah is the one. أَنزَلَ السَّكِينَةَ. Who brings down sakina. Or sakina could be what? هي نور يستقر في القلب. It is a light that enters into the heart of a believer. يثبت به التوجه إلى الحق. And through that light that enters into the heart, a person's attention and focus becomes firm upon the path of truth. ويتخلص عن الطيش. And it saves a person from deviation. Subhanallah. This is the effect of nur al-sakina. Some people say, oh, my iman has become so weak, Shaykh. My iman has gotten so weak. I'm so down and I'm so weak and I don't want to pray. And I don't. Subhanallah, you need sakina. You need some sakina supplements. This is what's going to help you increase your iman. لِيَزْدَادُوا إِيمَانًا مَعَ إِيمَانِهِمْ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself says, what is the effect of nur al-sakina descending? When the light of tranquility and the light of sakina descends upon the heart of a believer, this lam is allam natijiyya. Allam lin natija. What happens? Liyazdadu, yani natijatuhu. Natijatu inzal al sakina. Here, right? Is diadul iman fi qulub al mu'mineen. Is that the iman increases in the hearts of the believers. Allahumma rizqna ya rabbil alameen. May Allah ta'ala grant us that. So this is the second thing. Automatically, when a person is reciting the Quran, The nur of sakina and iman increases in our hearts. Number three, wa ghashiyatuhumur rahma, the place where the Quran is being recited. and the people who together are sitting to recite the Quran in the halaqa, what happens? غَشِيَتْهُمُ الرَّحْمَةِ The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends. Allahu Akbar. Now, we come back to our original point, right? فِي دَفْعِ الْبَلَاءِ بِتَعَلُّمِ الْقُرْآنِ وَقِرَاءَةِ الْقُرْآنِ In the chapter where it says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, people become worthy to incur the wrath of Allah. But when recitation of Quran is taking place, children are reading and reciting the Quran. صَرَفَ ذَلِكَ عَنْهُمْ Allah ta'ala takes away the azab that was meant upon them. Why? It's because that place where the Quran is being recited, غَشِيَتْهُمُ الرَّحْمَةِ غَشِيَتْهُمُ الرَّحْمَةِ They're being enveloped and covered by Allah ta'ala's mercy. So how can that place in which Allah's mercy is descending be worthy of Allah ta'ala's wrath? So this is why, brothers and sisters, subhanAllah, we are blessed with such a blessing. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ Verily of this Qur'an, Allah has revealed something which is a cure. Brothers and sisters, in this COVID-19 situation, in these circumstances that we are in, our shifa should be the recitation of Qur'an. InshaAllah, Allah will make this a shifa for us, for our communities, for our localities, for our neighborhood, for our masajid, for our families, for our state, for our nation, for the entire world. When we are reciting the Quran, غَشِيَتْهُمُ الرَّحْمَةِ Allah Ta'ala's rahmah descends and Allah Ta'ala's mercy descends. How can then the azab of Allah Ta'ala come in that place? May Allah Ta'ala give us the tawfiq. May Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala make our recitation of the Quran worthy of that mercy. And lastly, وَذَكَرَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَنْ عِنْدَهِ Last but not least, is that when we recite the Qur'an, Allah is telling His angels, oh my angels, look at my slaves. Look at them. They are reciting my book. They are making tilawat of Qur'an. They are sitting together and remembering me. Have they seen me? Have they seen me? Have they seen Jannah? Have they seen Jahannam? What are they asking? He said, no, Ya Allah, they have not seen you. They have not seen paradise. They have not seen the hellfire. He said, what do you think if they would have seen? Oh Allah, they would have been more desirous of you, they would have been more obedient to you, they would have been more asking of paradise, they would have been seeking protection and refuge from the fire even more. He said, then I make you a witness, O my angels, that I have forgiven all of them. Allahu Akbar. So these are the blessings, brothers and sisters. One great blessing of the recitation of the Quran is that it removes the calamities and it removes the wrath of Allah and it removes the anger of Allah and it protects us from the evils of shaitan. And inshallah, one night we will specifically focus, one specific night, just on that. How and which ayat and which verses of the Quran protect us from the evils of shaitan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to recite the Quran with this intention. The Ya Rabbil Alameen. وَنُنَزِّلُ You have said, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ Ya Rabbil Alameen, You have said in Your book Yourself that we have revealed of this Qur'an something which is a cure and it is a mercy for the believers. Oh Allah, make this a cure for this adversity we are in. For this calamity that has descended, make it a cure for this. And there's nothing is difficult for Allah. Allah Azza wa Jal Himself has said this is a cure. وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ And oh Allah Ta'ala, make it a rahmah that all baliyat and all musibat, all calamities and all adversities should be removed from us through the barakah of the recitation of the Quran. May Allah Ta'ala give us tawfiq.